We are reading Ada Rasa Sudanidhi, verse 136. All glories to Sri Radha, who is a zenith of Rasa. From Sri Radha's every limb, blazing, nectarian Rasa is flowing. All glories to Sri Radha, who is the only ocean that is filled with love. All glories to Sri Radha, who is the only nectar ocean of elegance. All glories to Sri Radha, who is an ocean containing the essence of motherly compassion.
Yeah.
All glories to Sri Radha, who is the birthplace of a kingdom of newly entering useful sweetness, and who is a great ocean of mysteries. May I go on?
Yes.
Sri Radha, the great mysterious ocean. Commentary. In the Gita, the Lord says, he who is devoted to me is dear to me. But the person who surrenders to Sri Radha's lotus feet is most dear to Sri Govinda. In Brihat Bhagavatamrita, Sloka 2.7.11, it is written, Sri Gokumar said, Ujana Saman, I have come here in topmost bliss, ignoring the bliss of meeting this Krishna, having attained the order of Sri Radha. I don't wait for the company of Sri Krishna because I feel paramount bliss from attaining Sri Radha's order. Gopkumar was a devotee with fraternal love, love as a brother. Therefore, he was most eager for Sri Krishna's company. Then, why did he promptly reject Sri Krishna's company after receiving Sri Radha's order? The answer to this is, following the order of Sri Radha automatically accomplishes Sri Krishna's satisfaction and even more bliss will be attained in Sri Krishna's company. Please, Gurudev, could you explain how it will be more blissful in Sri Krishna's company when we are following Sri Radha's order?
You need more. Mitchell, please read more.
Sripad sees Sri Radha as a great mysterious ocean. Although it is shoreless, It is nevertheless hidden. The truth about Radha is described in a hidden way in the Vedas. And in the essence of all the Vedanta, in the Srimad Bhagavata, Sri Shukamuni also describes Sri Radha in a hidden way, just as the soul is undeniably present in the body and can be felt as such, but can still not be located. Similarly, Sri Radha's name is not literally written down anywhere in the Bhagavata, but her presence can be felt throughout this holy book by an experienced devotee. This mysterious ocean is not material. It is made of transcendentally blissful, sweet love. Just
that the point. Sweet love. And it comes, unconditional love. It comes from mercy of Sri Radha. In friendship, in any relation, this sweetness in love is coming. It's our mercy. Go on.
Just as different oceans meet in the Pacific Ocean, so also different oceans meet in the great ocean of love named Radha. Each of her limbs emit verströmen, emit the splendid erotic flavor of love that floats into the Pacific Ocean. The maidservants of Sri Radha can understand that better than anyone else. Streams of emotional erotic ornaments, Bhavalankara, like Hava, Bhava, Lila, Vilasa, and Kila Kinshit, emit from her every limb to satisfy all of Shyamasundara's desires and to make him very happy. The maidservants can witness that every time when Radha meets Shyam. Another ocean that enters into the Pacific Ocean of Mahabharata is Lavanyaka Sindhu, the only nectar ocean of elegance. The word eka, or only, is used in this respect to show that nothing in this world can be compared to this ocean.
Yes. So that is what you said? Opulence. What is it? That is opulence. That all the oceans, all the rivers, oceans, they come to the point of Radha. Means all the religion, if not going for love, is not religion. Every religion will point out to the love. Then is the realization. Then is the spiritual life.
So, Gurudev, may I share something?
Yes, yeah.
Okay. Perhaps there is one thing, one material thing that is also real elegant. It's a pearl. I think a pearl is an example that suffering is grace. Perhaps Mother Earth is offering this ornament to Sri Radha. A pearl is built of a sand corn in a conch, and the conch is heard, and it embraces the sand corn with layers of Perlmutter, one layer after the other, in the depths of the Pacific Ocean with the waves. And then this sand corn, which hurts the conch, becomes a pearl, a perfect form, shimmering, glimmering, because the light breaks so that it gets a glance. And a pearl is very resistant, but not hard. It is of a stuff, but it seems to be silky. And I see as if Mother Bhumi is bowing down to Sri Radha, and she is offering this pearl to her, and Sri Radha is accepting it.
Yeah.
As an ornament, so as similarly as Krishna accepted the peacock feather.
Yeah.
Suffering is grace.
Yes. Right.
Another ocean that enters into the Pacific Ocean. Of Mahabhav is Lavanyaka, Sindhu, the only nectar ocean of elegance. The word eka only is used in this respect to show that nothing in this world can be compared in this ocean. There's one pearl, but you said the opulence, the whole ocean is Sri Radha. The waves of this delectable nectar ocean of elegance can even steal Govinda's heart. The maid servants can witness how his heart and mind are struck by the waves of this ocean of Lavanya whenever Krishna meets Srimati.
Only maid servant, Chaitanya Manovishtam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what is that?
Sri Chaitanya Manovishtam, Stapitam Yena Uttane, Swayam Rupa Kadamayam, Tadati Swapadantikam.
So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Manovishtam, to give this Manjari vow to feel the waves of love of Radha and Krishna. You read this line. Waves, ocean in waves. You see all ocean meet in Radha's, na? And these waves coming from the ocean is a waves means the feeling of Radha for Krishna. Purpose is the waves. And who watch? The Dasi of Radhika is watching. Read again this line, paragraph.
The waves of
no,
this.
Do one line more.
Another ocean that enters into the Pacific Ocean of Mahabharat is Lavanyaika, the only nectar ocean of elegance. The word eka, or only, is used in this respect to show that nothing in this world can be compared to this ocean. The waves of this delectable nectar ocean of elegance can even steal Govinda's heart. The maid servants can witness how his heart and mind are struck by the waves of this ocean of Lavanya whenever Sri Krishna meets Srimati.
Yes.
Yeah. Another ocean that meets with the Pacific Ocean of Mahabharat is Puru, Kripa, Vatsalya, Sarambudi. The ocean of the ascents of great motherly compassion. The only compassionate gift to the conditioned souls in the material world is prema, or love of God.
See that? Yeah. Again, read this line.
Yes.
Repeat this line.
The ocean, it's another ocean that meets with the Pacific Ocean. The ocean of the ascents of great motherly compassion. The only compassionate gift to the conditioned souls in the material world is prema, is love of God. This is a great treasure and the great gain of mankind.
One word you left, it comes from Guru Kripa. That's it. Add this word, then read again.
Another ocean that meets with the Pacific Ocean of Mahabharat is Puru, Kripa, Vatsalya, Sarambudi.
1 minute, Sudhir.
Yeah, this is the next sentence, Guru, the ocean of the essence of great motherly compassion. Huh?
Yeah,
that was coming, you know.
Yeah.
Sorry. Yes.
Yeah.
Again?
Yes. Yeah.
Another ocean that meets with the Pacific Ocean of Mahabharat is Puru, Kripa, Vatsalya, Sarambudi. The ocean of the ascents of great motherly compassion.
Yeah.
The only compassionate gift to the conditioned soul.
Guru Kripa motherly. This is very important one. Read this. This is the most important thing. Our Guru is like a mother. Right.
Guru Kripa Vatsalya Sarambudi.
Yeah, this much. Explain?
Yes.
No, read this.
The only compassionate gift to the conditioned souls in the material world is prema, or love of God. This is the great treasure and the great gain of mankind.
Yeah.
The most fortunate soul can immediately become submerged in the great nectarian ocean of sweetness of Radha and Krishna's love simply by once seeing Sri Radhika. And the maidservants are always sprinkled by the waves of Sri Radhika's motherly love.
But where is the Guru Kripa?
That is only in this...
There is an explanation.
No, that was some Sanskrit. Puru, it says Puru Kripa, but I don't know if this is Puru or Puru.
Yes. Okay.
But Gurudev is completely right. Even if the Guru word is not there, Gurudev, you are so right. It's so beautiful. Because without Guru Kripa, what else is possible? Jai Ho.
Jai Ho, Tarun, Babaji.
This motherly love comes from Gurudev. And when he Kripa, Ahit ki Kripa happened, then desires come to come to my constitutional position. Because this seed comes from Radhika to his Dasi, and that is Guru Mandir. And then she has to give, because it's not direct. I went there. He's introduced by her dasi. We are not qualified, but her recommendation, Swamini has to accept. Dasi recommendation is only that is Ahit ki Kripa. That mercy is Ahit ki Kripa. Sri Radhika.
Yes, please. Another ocean that meets,
So there are two hands. First you meditate. One is a
motherly ocean of compassion.
First ocean is
elegant.
That she is mad in love of Krishna. One point.
And
is this, that all oceans are going there, all rivers are going there for one point, for Allah, not Madanakya Mahabhav, only to get the feeling and love. All religions are going for that. Prema.
Divine love.
And here is Madanakya Mahabhav. Is feeling, highest feeling and highest feeling, where the love originates, it happens. That is the is what? Elegant.
The elegance, Lavanya. The ocean of Lavanya.
Who control the whole universe, controlled by Krishna. He is in control of Radhika. Mothers also want that every day Radhika come to cook for Krishna. Yasoda.
And Sri Radha is
also want to be with Krishna. Cow wants to be with Krishna, and the baby cow also wants to love to Krishna. Or Vrindavan, Brajavasis want to love and do for Krishna. And that Krishna is mad in the love of Radhika. You can see that Lavanya, elegance of Radhika. How much detailed things are there, that too is such. Why? What is there? That is the beauty of Radhika. And for the Manjari, see, Gurudev introduced us. So she is the mother of the Manjaris. They are all very child. There are no qualification. But any baby who born took the birth now, we took birth now, like by mercy of Gurudev in my Siddha there. So then what is our situation? Newborn baby. And how newborn baby grow? Only by the love of mother and her breastfeeding. And see the and baby also don't want to leave mama. That is the Manjari of sadhana. Like a mother's shadow is baby. The baby is the shadow of mother. Where mother goes, baby goes, because his existence is because of mother. That is the vatsalya of our Swami. Ahet ki kripa of Gurudev. When this desire comes in Guru, by mercy of Gurudev, in our sadhak deha, to reach to our constitutional position, then Guru Manjari and Dasi of Radhika and Radhika accept us to the psychic baby.
I want to share something.
Yeah, welcome. I want everyone to share.
I remember also our Gurudev, Srila Gurudev Narayan Maharaj, he always said that the Gurudev is like a mother. And the children, the babies, us, we are sitting on the lap of the mama and making pee-pee and kaka, but they are not bothering. They are doing this, but the mother doesn't care. She's just cleaning again, and then they can go on. He used to give this example.
Yeah. This is the highest teacher. We cannot get any place in the universe only by the grace of Siddha Mahatmas, they give this mercy, who is become Kinkari of Radhika, who become Dasi of Radhika, they can give this mercy to connect us. And we feel so fortunate to come to our constitutional position. It's nothing to do. It's not sadhana bhakti can do us. It's ahet ki kripa. Ahet ki kripa. When Guru give mercy, Narayan Maharaj is telling always, it just depends upon the sanskara. Previous sanskara, if it's there, greed is come. We become greedy. Without previous sanskara is no cause. Previous sanskara make us greedy. And that moment, only we can do we can beg for this, beg to the Guru, please give me, please give me, please give me. Or we can borrow from some Mahatmas, Vaishnavas, begging,
stealing us,
and steal. We know it's steal. We steal many things from Gurudev. You don't know. I steal from Narayan Maharaj, beg, borrow, and steal. It's not stealing. Stealing the word of Gurudev is stealing. But this stealing changed the life. You see, beg, borrow, steal. And if you steal this word from his teaching, life will not change. Say me. It will change or not change?
It will change
108%. So what he said? He said right thing. Beg, borrow, and steal. We don't steal it. We don't beg it from Vaishnava. We don't beg it from the sadhus. We have to beg it. We don't use our false ego. We have to beg. Begging is madhukali. Begging is asking, please give me. Give me something to survive. This is begging. When I have nothing, then I can beg. If I am over full, I will not go to begging for the bread. I have to empty to beg it. I have to be greedy for that. Greed makes you to beg. Greed make you to borrow, and greed make you to steal. Where is the good thing? Steal it. Steal it. No? Why I say, hidden path of devotion is a Bhagavad Gita for Raga Bhakti. If you want to enter in Raga Bhakti, it's a Bhagavad Gita. Like a basic, to you can crystal clear which stage you can go and how you can come to consciousness position. If you want to understand Prabhupada, page 4, Sarup and Sarup Siddhi and Mallow, 5 Mallow, what he said, you have to go from hidden path of devotee. Every place, sadhus, rasikas are telling. Raga bhakti is the way to build your flat to leave the constitutional position. But a constitutional position, you make your body, and if you have no place, flat, room for living, a kitchen for cooking, how you will live there? That is constitutional position. Constitutional position means you identify your sarupa. And when you are in sarupa, then all your problem gone of sadhak there. Like I born in Mugir. And I'm living now in Vrindavan. When I move from Mugir to Vrindavan, my all problem is gone from Mugir. I done with myself. I'm free. So similarly, if you are living in your senses, body and false ego, you have to face it. And when you got your constitutional position of your soul, you're done. You visit from your home, your place to the material body to do something and go back. Like a city flat. And one in a farm flat, 2 flats you have. You come living in city home and working and living and working and living. And if you make one home in a farmhouse and you start living and sometime go here, sometime go there, like Mohini was in farmhouse, sometime here, sometime there, sometime there. You start like here, and you start this thing here, then your problem of city is gone. Or not gone. Yes. Why you're catching? They are not catching you. You catching, then it's there. But they leave you. Right? Garanga? I am catching you, but they're not catching us. So they're gone. And when you have a greed for Radhika, everything is gone. Everything is gone. Then Krishna help you that you become free from his Mahamaya and do right the service to myself. You give more time that she is happy. She has to serve because most loving person of Krishna is Radha. And when somebody serves to Radha, Krishna is the most happy to see that. I was one time in Dora Savinath, there was one pastime happened. Our Bhagavati Didi organized. And he organized one pastime, Krishna. All the sakhis when come to Krishna, he asked tax from them. And this is, you know, what is the tax of Krishna? He's a butter, he's a yogurt. This is external. But the tax of Krishna is very special for gopis. So everybody has to give tax. And Gopi Bhai also like to pay tax. Gopi Bhai is the solution. Then they want to give tax. But one Manjari also comes there. That Krishna Gopi. He was sitting, he stand, and he went to the Manjari, and he has a one lotus flower. He said, "For you is this." I was so excited to see this in Switzerland. I cannot say you. When this happening, I go and give flat dandava to the Manjari and to Krishna. I said, wow, this is Manjari Bhav, where Krishna offer presentation to the Manjari. Why? This Manjari will not give for herself. She will bring to Savani, to his boss. This is Vatsalya of Radhika. Lavanya is for Krishna, and a Vatsalya side is for us. Understand? Go.
In the Dankheli Leela, there is also sometimes Krishna is saying, "Okay, I want my tax."
Yeah.
And then they say the gopis, "No, no, no, we don't give you. You're like a cowboy, you know? We cannot give you anything." And then he says, "Oh, okay, then I'll take Rupa and Rati. I'll take them as my tax. But they're so dear and loyal to Radharani, so they will never stay with him." So Krishna knows that through that, he will get Radharani, that she has to stay with him.
I see that. There, O Gopinath, you see, understand him against it.
Achha, yeah. No, in this, what Gurudev was describing, this Leela which he saw in Schwabenalp is also known as the Dankheli Leela, the tax collection, and it's very beautiful. It has so many different nuances and sequences. So Mohan Krishna tries many things because the ultimate tax, what he wants, is a kiss from Radharani's lips. But Radharani and the gopis are in this Vama Madhya, like in this opposite mood. They don't want to make it easy for him. So as Gurudev said, Lalita and Vishakha, they kind of are inclined. They would even go and give the tax, but Rupa and Rati will never. So he says, "Okay, I will take them. I will take them as my tax." But they are so dear and loving to Radharani, they would never do that. So in the end, he knows that she will has to give herself to him to protect her manjaris from him. So this was one of the leelas which I just heard some time ago.
So Rupa and Rati he wants. That Radharani automatic will come because of Rupa and Rati. And what they say, Rupa and Rati, if they cannot ask, Krishna cannot ask from. If I say, if Krishna asks, he said, I can give everything to you, but not my constitutional body, my soul, my body means not sadhak deha, siddha deha. This is not given by you. You give soul after soul to me. But siddha deha is given by my swami. You not give me. There is no your right to ask from me. I can give everything to you, but not so many things I can give you. And you have no right to ask that. This is Manjari. Understand? See Chaitanya?
Chaitanya Mano Vistam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Kadapisvapadam.
Sri Chaitanya
Manovistam.
Manovistam. Manovistam is? What is Manovistam?
Innermost heart's desire.
Desire. Innermost heart desire of Chaitanya. What is?
Stapitam yena bhutale.
What is that, you know? Krishna becomes subject and Radha becomes object. Adi Leela 4 canto, see that. Krishna himself says, I am a subject, you are my object.
I am the servant, you are the goal.
You are the goal. Understand Mohini or not? Make this or not this way. This is the point, serious. If it comes to you, you set. And what is the goal of our life? Before was faith, hope, love, then God. Faith, hope, love and God. Jesus said, our acharyas are telling different things. Prem prayojan. What is meaning of prem prayojan? The way is love. And goal is also that. No God goal. Here, no God goal. The goal is, this is Manovistam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Please try to understand. Avideha, the day you will get the practice in Avideha, prem will be your prayojan. Sri Radha. Mm-hmm. If you practice in your Abhideha, prem will be your prayojan. But what is Abhideha, that you have to realize. Abhideha will bring you prem prayojan. Sri Radha. Sambandha is the most important thing. And without Guru Kripa, Naam Kripa, Ist Kripa, you not go in without Ist Dev in Sambandha. You need the base, where to relate. You need name, you need form, you need the person to relate. and that is your Ishtadev. Without Ishtadev, Sambandha not come. Suniti, you want to say sorry? Yes, say it's
good. Yeah, they were talking about this process of Abhideya.
Yeah, please come. Yeah.
And Sambandha. And
no, you want to say something else?
What could it?
I don't know, but I it was flowing, so it comes out.
Yes, Srimati Radhika is our Ishtadev in the process of Radha Dasi. But to serve her, we cannot really serve her with our material senses, right? We need our constitutional position. We need our Dasi, our relationship to her, that she has accepted us, and that we come to our spiritual senses. And this is the process of Abhideya. And this is given by the mercy of our Rupa Goswami, Rupa Manjari. And our Guru Manjari is our helper on this path because she has accepted us in the shelter of Srimati Radhika. And slowly, slowly, by this process of not only knowing that I am not this body, but we are given the mood of the Dasi, the Ekadas Bhav, the different feelings of the Dasi. And slowly, slowly, we are practicing in the association of like-minded devotees of our Guru, Guru Manjari. Then we can come to this slowly deep feelings towards Srimati Radhika. It's our Aradhya Devi. Sri Narayan Maharaj would always say Aradhya Devi. And I love this word because it is so soft and so feminine. It's not that I am there yet. I am practicing, but I have this hope. And the strong hope will carry us. Like you were explaining, Rudin, that this Guru Kripa is a motherly, affectionate love that will carry us babies through the different steps in our path of bhakti to Srimati Radhika. And we were also speaking these days. I want to share this again because it was really touching my heart that Lord Chaitanya went to Ishvara Puripad and he was asking two mantras from him, especially Kama Gayatri and Gopal Mantra. And so this Kama Gayatri, we all have been chanting maybe 20, 30 years sometimes. But to really feel it and to come closer to the inner meaning of it. Something happened these days that some mercy came. We were usually thinking that Krishna has the Pushpa Balaya. He's looking with his merciful glance. But then another rasic meaning was added by our dear Gurudev, and he said that actually Srimati Radhika is giving the sidelong glances to Krishna. And then something will happen because the mantra will see that. She can meditate. We are the Dasi in this aspiring mode. And we can meditate how Srimati Radhika is giving the sidelong glances to Sri Krishna, to Mohan. And then they are meeting. So this is the Kama Gayatri.
One is a rag.
Mm-hmm.
One-sided, and one is anurag, both sides. That's the anurag. And one side is going on, it's very good. I'm trying to go in love, in relation. But if happened both sides, it's more relishing. When bhav come close to rasa, bhav, feeling in us, when feeling close to rasa, that's the ananda. And what is feeling? You want to know?
Jai ho.
Feeling is mahabhav, one drop is a feeling. When the feeling is start coming, mahabhav mercy start happening to you. You start living in the feeling. One is no feeling and one is a feeling. If he's not in feeling, he's a sick person. You can see this. Some sickness is there, physical. And if he's living in the feeling, there is no sickness. Because he's in feeling. Why sickness? He's not a, this type of bottle, right? It's no feeling. This has no feeling. We are not like this. We are sure body, material, senses, material, ego also very problematic. All are problematic. Plastic body is also problematic. You see plastic body is also problem. But inside, the soul is also there. That is part and parcel of divine. So we can develop our feeling part. And this feeling will bring you to rasa. And who is that? Raso Vaisa. Raso Vaisa. Who is Raso Vaisa? Rasik Sekhar, you know, who is this? This is Krishna. Without feeling, there is no way to reach rasa. So meeting of feeling and rasa, when it comes close, only Manjari can check this. That is their Raman. And who is getting Ananda? Only Manjari can feel and see that Ananda. Not outside. Sri Ram. Oh. They have to read, huh? Yes, reading. Please.
Sri Radha, Sri Radhika sees her maid servants as being,
you see,
as being non-different from her.
My God, non-different, because you see this, you feel the light, the shadow will be there. This bottle has a shadow. And Radhika's shadow is Manjari, Dasi. Imagine if she is not there, shadow can exist. It's non-different. She is living and I am in her shadow. The moment I will forget her, she will not leave and sadhu will finish. Again, I will come back to my sadhak there. All craziness will happen inside me. False ego will come. And I will suffer in this material world. Nobody can stop me. Yes. Again, repeat this.
Sri Radhika sees her maid servants as being non-different from her.
Sri Radhika.
There is also a great kingdom in the Pacific Ocean, the very wealthy island of Radhika's newly entering useful beauty. Just as there are many enjoyable objects in a wealthy kingdom, there are also many enjoyable items of Radhika, adolescent sweetness in the vast ocean of her body. The maid servants are fortunate enough to witness how enjoyable this is to Krishna when the divine couple meets. The word Mahanidhi can mean great jewel or great ocean. In this case, it is a Virodaha Alankara, a metaphor of a contradiction. There is from Adi Lila, everyone knows that lotus flowers are born from the Ganga, but that the Ganga is born from a lotus is highly contradictory. Now, the Ganga is born from the lotus feet of Lord Vishnu. This is a highly astonishing ornament of contradictions. Everyone knows that jewels come from the ocean, but in this case, the great oceans of Radha's nectarian erotic love, her nectarian beauty, her great mercy, and her motherly love come from the great hidden jewel of Sri Radha's form.
Yes.
It's a great, indescribable, and supreme jewel of love.
Sri Radha.
Thus ends this verse of Radha Radha Sudhanidhi.
Anyone to share? Please, Gaurachandra, Gopinath, please come near. Share. Oh, Gopija, please come. Tarun Baba, oh, I forget here. You forget me, I also. Tarun Baba, please share something. Your same picture, yeah. Your darshan is great. Yeah. Yeah.
I like what you said, Gurudev. I like best that actually all that this wonderful experiences the Manjaris can have, and that they are non-different from Radhika, and that they are so special in the connection with Radhika. For me, always it boils down, especially on such an auspicious day, like your appearance day. For me, always this is only possible. Even to hear it is like is because of Guru Kripa. Without Guru Kripa, we have no possible entrance in this nectar ocean. I sit here, and Govinda Priya, we sit here. And we can hear this beautiful explanation from you, and wonderfully read by Sudevi Jaya. Oh. Really, really wonderful. Really wonderful. Great seva to Baba.
Very
so nice. So nice and very sweet. So this is, for me, this is only possible because Guru Kripa is flowing. Even if Baba is not here, you are here and the Vaishnavas are here. But Guru Kripa is the most important principle to gain entrance. And like you said, this Manubhishtam, this heart's innermost desire of Mahaprabhu is that we can relish and practice Raganuga Bhakti in the wake of the Ragatmikas. And this is only possible by first what Rupa Goswami is saying, Guru Padashraya. Guru Padashraya means to take shelter at the lotus feet of Gurudev. This is the beginning of the 64 Angas of Bhakti, and for me personally, the most important one, because it's like opening a treasure box and then everything is coming. If we don't follow and if we don't put the words Guru Mukhopadma in our hearts, nothing, no Amrita can flow and nothing can happen. So this is what I like most when you said, when you heard Guru Kripa instead of Puru Kripa, I was so ecstatic because actually this is the most important thing, that actually Guru Kripa is whatever is there. And then of course in the perfected stage, Guru Manjari is there and Guru Manjari is with us at every step. So for me, I take this for my learning and for my education, that whenever we read such a beautiful thing, I have to remember that everything is only possible by the shelter and the mercy of Gurudev. So this is what I can always share. This is for me the most important principle, and we are lucky that we can have this sharing and this meeting and all these wonderful things because of the grace of Guru and the sadhus. Dhanyavad. Jai Ho.
Gurudev would like to listen to you, Brajanath Prabhu. Will you share something from your heart?
Let's mute that.
So, Devi, you have to open the mic.
This microphone on, Shank.
Kannst du das machen, Bukman? Es ist grau.
Sorry.
Yes. Oh, now we can see you.
I'm very happy to be here today. And that this day was so special. I knew something. But to be with all of you, especially with Maharaji and Big Most Sister, darling Sister Suniti, she is there also with Maharaji, and to hear the glories of Sri Radhika's loving services, how they are oceans of elegance, an ocean of motherly affection. Especially the motherly affection is coming to see Guru in the babies. We are babies. I love it. So today, and it's our motherly affection. So I'm sharing, hearing the beautiful sharing of Sri Rasa.
We need to.
It's just. The audio is very low, so Devi, könnt ihr da ein bisschen aufdrehen für euch?
Sorry. Now it is better?
Yes. Okay. Yes.
Yeah. Oh, here it is. I'm going like this. Now it is better, yeah? We are hearing from Sri Guru.
Yes.
Yes.
Sri Radha and hearing the glories of Sri Radha, especially that are coming through her maid servants, the Manjaris, then we also feel so much inspiration to want to develop and practice the process to develop these beautiful emotions. In Radharasa Sudhanidhi, we have heard from Sri Gurudev how Krishna, although he is Supreme Personality, but in Braja, he becomes completely fascinated when he simply receives the fragrance that comes with the breeze from the veil of Srimati Radharani. Srimati Radharani is sitting at Radhakunda and Krishna sitting at the other side of Radhakunda. What happens between them? Very deep ocean of love and affection with so many beautiful symptoms. But Krishna is praying, how I can appease the soaking mood, the ma, Srimati Radharani, my beloved. Then the breeze coming from the other side of Radhakunda, carrying the fragrance of only the veil, only the part of the veil of Srimati Radhika. And Krishna becoming completely ecstatic and fascinated. Now my life is successful. Krishna is thinking. So that is the power of the love of Srimati Radharani. And that is her beauty. And only that motherly affection, that ocean, that inspires us to also anyhow taste and participate in that beautiful festival of Radha Rasa Sudhanidhi. Not only that, that same Krishna who is so much glorified by all the Vedas, who is that same Supreme Personality, when even the sidelong glance of Srimati Radhika touches his eyes, he fades, his peacock feather falls, his pitambar drops from his shoulder. Not only that, his dearmost companion, his flute, drops under. He cannot maintain any composure. So that's Srimati Radhika is our Swamini. And I pray today to all of you, especially to Maharaji, who is helping all of us, nourishing our childlike, baby-like needs, that we are growing up nicely and becoming one-pointed in that seva that Sri Rupa has come to distribute, and which is manifested through Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur in hidden part of devotion. When I see Maharaj, I see hidden part of devotion. The heart of Maharaji. So that Krishna completely faints, and his friends, they don't know what to do anymore. So who doesn't want to be, who doesn't want to become inspired, who doesn't want to receive the nourishing love and affection coming from Sri Guru, who is the embodiment of that Radha Pandya Dasi, who is realized, who is not Mother Jiva, but actually the ocean of bodily nourishment, compassion, giving us that beautiful inspiration, that what service is more attractive to be under the ashraya of Sri Radha. And that's what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to give Swabhakti Sri Yon. to enhance the beauty of the pastime. This is our greatest, most amazing fortune. Jewel that is amazing. From that amazing portion of Sri Radhika's lovely affection for us, and also the inspiration that we find when we hear these beautiful lilas, how one day in our Siddhartha we can also fully relish and participate in that brain shape of that Bhakti Rasa. Jai Ho! Jai Ho! Maharaj, Jai Ho! Jai Shri Prabodhananda Saraswati Pad. Jai Brenda wants to say two words.
I'm so fortunate to be here. It's also been a surprise for everyone and for us even more. And I'm just thinking, when I was reading Vilav Kushmanjali, there's a beautiful description about the Manjalis, and that when the Krishna being comes to the flower of Srimati Radhika, he tries to enter and tries to relish the nectar which comes from her lotus mouth, lotus face, and lotus lips. And then the flowers start shaking. But if you see a tulsi tree, you see the flowers, but then you see the Manjalis. And then what happens when the Krishna bee comes to the flower, then all the Manjalis also start shaking, but even more than the flower. So whatever the Manjalis, whatever Srimati Radhika tastes, actually the Manjalis even taste even more. So they only want to serve their Swamini, not because of their selfishness, but just to enhance their eternal loving pastime. So I was just thinking, beautiful example, and I'm sure, Maharaji, if you can elaborate more on that, but it's such a beautiful description in Vilak Kushmandali. So we are so lucky to be in this this Guru Rupa Rupa Bhadika, because as you explained, Sri Rupa Manjali, he's the Manobhishtam, and he knows exactly. We were hearing so many beautiful qualifications of Sri Rupa Manjali and Rupa Goswami just 2 or 3 weeks ago, how actually only through her mercy, she is the Rupa of Srimati Radhika herself. So actually she knows everything about Srimati Radhika, and everyone is her servant. So we just pray by the mercy of the real beach bosses like Maharaji, and that we can also become Gopi Pada Kamaleo Das 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 An Dasi.
I remember I see Brinda Didi in Miami, and I bring some vegetables for Maharaji, Dharan Maharaji Gurudev. That time I was in
You came to Miami?
Miami, vegetable, from the fresh vegetable. From
You brought some makata, some drumsticks, I remember.
From the, I went to the Sukhdev place.
Trinidad.
I was Trinidad, and I bring from there vegetable, and Brinda Didi was cooking there. Wow. And she was so happy. I was so happy to see her face that he will like to eat. I was so happy.
And Maharaj,
I still, when I remember your name, and then I remember that Miami, how you was accepted with love, that was my, that was full of mercy to me.
I remember that you came and our Gurudev embraced you. And then I saw you with each other so affectionately, speaking in this Brajpasi language, this Bihari language, Brajpuri language. And then I thought, oh, instead, my Gurudev, so much affection to you. And that also melted my heart, and I felt my day was so lucky.
Maharshi, I never listen about the Radha words. I am traveling many places I go, but it was missing in my life, name of Radha. And I was in Chaitanya Gauri Amat. He is talking and singing about Radharani, only glorifying. Yeah. And then, what I can say you, from that day, I always try to be good.
There.
So, there I bet. So that way, that way, I was, what I'm telling,
because he was speaking about Radhika.
Radhika. And then I start, where he goes, I go like that.
Following.
And I tried to hiding this his backside. But Prem Prayojan is said to me, and he called, come. He called me, and when I sit one time, I see he is living in the Bhavavesh, in his Siddha there. And sometime he come to his sadhak there, but he always in siddha there. That was my special attraction to get some money, that vibration from him. I say you. And because I practice in my 76, 70, with my mercy of my Gurudev, this practice was there. So I feel that way. Class chalata. Kitne log hain?
Hello.
Nana kitten to unke
90
log hai class mein baithe hai koi baat nahi.
Vibration rooted of this.
So that vibration I feel.
Baba, anti band kar.
Association of Siddhadeha, who lives in Siddhadeha, that vibration is important. He, so many times Maharaj said to me to say something, actually, I never said. I am receiving from him. I come to receive, to steal. And he gave me. And now I'm stealing from Anandas Babaji. I know Anandas Babaji. He is coming to my temple. He stay here. Long time to give class, Baba. And Narayan Maharaj also come to this temple. He knows about that, this temple very well. So all mercy, I got it. And Prabhupada said, I was with your grandfather. He also come here. So it's all mercy come to me. And all in Siddhadeha, they are Radha Dasi. They are all one place in service. They are not another place. Even Swami Maharaj is also in the service of Radha Dasi. They are all one place. He is not Sakha or anything. If he is Sakha, then is no Rupani. Something else we are pleading. Oh, they are Rasik. You see the Sridhar Maharaj book in German, in a
Research of the Lost Servant.
Lost Servants. Bhakti Siddhanta is telling stories that the king persons are Krishna Bhakta. We are not like that. We are Radha Bhakta.
When they were circumventing, they were doing parikrama of Radha Kunda. Then the devotees, they came to Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati Thakur. And they said, oh, the king of Divan, he is a special person. Him and his family are doing parikrama. And then he said, yes, but they have a different perspective. They are doing for Krishna. They don't understand that we are doing for Radha's mercy. They are doing for Krishna's.
Right or not? And Chaitanya is Krishna, right? But took the mood of Radhika and covered in Radhika's
bhav.
What is meaning? He become Dasi of Radhika. Krishna, that is Manjari Bhav. Radha Dasi is Manjari. And Krishna say, I become Manjari, you also love me, then practice like this.
I become Ashraya Radhika.
If you love me, if you are Krishna Bhakta, you also practice like me. Sri Radhe, this is Manovistham of Chaitanya. Sri Radhe.
Sridhar Maharaj also writes in this book, if we somehow manage to get into the circle of Radhika to become her maidservant, then our future is assured.
Yeah.
So we don't have to worry then.
Yeah, okay. Sudevi, I'm very proud of you. I'm very proud of you.
So, it's an auspicious moment. It's like a holy moment.
And I want you and Sukriti and all your group also, Prem Priya is also there. All your group make unite with love and care each other devotee and share your things. Only we can give this. thank you. You are keeping very nice and rich and always invite sadhus and make satsang.